Welcome to this part dedicated to the new pie menu. With the exception of the windows and doors tools, every applied tool is permanent, which is a key distinction from parametric tools. It is important to note that the advantage here is that the tool applies solely to the selected faces and edges. Important note, if you've just updated BagaPie or are using it for the first time, switching to edit mode will prompt you to set up the tool. Just click the button, then restart Blender. This is only necessary the first time you use it. After that, it won't be needed and the tools will show up as expected. We will begin with the exceptions. First of all, the Windows and Doors tool operates in a similar manner. Imagine I have a wall. I just need to select one face or several, preferably quadrilaterals, but it also works on N-gons. Press D, and on the left side, you will find the Windows and Doors. They are quite similar, although the interface varies slightly depending on the parameters. In this case, we will use classic Windows. Selected faces are copied in a new mesh. We see that we are out of edit mode on the original mesh since the windows are now a new object. Upon leaving edit mode, we can see that there is a window object, our original object, and a hidden boolean. The latter does not need editing. If I select my windows and go into edit mode, I can pick a window and move it. This will not alter the original topology of the mesh. What we are moving is the face that creates the window and also serves as boolean. To the right, there is the window components. A lot of variations can be generated. It's your responsibility to test and manage them, finding the best settings. At the bottom, like other modifiers, you can manage materials. It's the only parametric modifier in the Edit Mode Pie menu. For N-gons like this circle, the flaps will not be generated. They are automatically disabled. At this time, this feature exclusively supports quadrilaterals. Please note that after creating the window, you can utilize loop cuts with Ctrl+R to control how your windows are divided. Each window's frame will adjust to its dimensions accordingly, but you can disable them. Doors are quite similar. There are presets for both single and double doors, but you can easily convert them to double, switch their opening direction, or change which side the door is on, just as you can manage the opening. Please note that if the wall is excessively thick, you will have to increase the boolean depth. It is set by default for a wall thickness of 20 cm. Now, we will look at a variant of tools available in the procedural pie menu. These are the face to tools. We have face to grid, paving, perforated grid, or plank. In our demo, we will only use grid. A very important point is that as long as the parameters are displayed here, you can modify the grid as you wish. Once you click somewhere else, the modifier will be applied, and you cannot edit it anymore. Next, let's take a look to the cable generator. It works quite simply, you just need to select edges. D and cable creator. The parameters are basic, but the key highlight is its deformation feature. You can boost the intensity of the deformation and adjust the frequency. The frequency corresponds to the number of deformations along the curve. The higher the frequency, the fewer deformations there will be, allowing you to increase the intensity of the deformations. If you lower the frequency, the cable will tend to be more chaotic. Change the seed to achieve the desired result. The cable will deform according to the surface. Now, let's take a look at the Boolean Through tool. This modifier creates a Boolean operation based on the selection, for instance. Select a target face D, Boolean Through, and we'll get this type of hole. The modifier also works on complex shapes like bevels. It uses the average normal to choose its direction. You have all the Boolean parameters at the bottom left. In some cases, you may encounter unfinished Booleans. To fix this, simply increase the offset. Its operation is quite straightforward. He projects the points of the selected faces and project the point onto the opposite face. Now let's examine the Tessellate tool. It will substitute a face with an object you select. For instance, I have this damage object here. Over there is my object. In edit mode, I choose the faces I wish to swap out for my damage, D, tessellate. For now, nothing is happening, which is normal because I need to provide the mesh to use, damage. I remove the original face and that's done. Note that this tool only works on quadrilaterals. Also note that the position of the object's origin is very important because it determines where the object will be placed relative to the existing face. Now let's look at the insert circle, always the same. You can select any face, whether it's a triangle, a quad, or an N-gon, the insert circle. You can manage the rotation, the number of sides, or its offset. Keep in mind that the base radius is not set automatically. you might need to enlarge or reduce it, particularly when working on small or large scales. Now let's look at the array along shape. It is very similar to its parametric version. However, the it allows for deformation of the object that is repeated along the shape. Everything happens in edit mode. You cannot have two distinct objects. Here I will join them. In edit mode, select only the faces you want to repeat. Everything selected will be repeated. The modifier utilizes the closest surface to use it as a repetition. The array along shape enables snap deform to deform the object in relation to the surface. As it relies on the normal of our object, you might need to enhance the precision of the deformation. This will cause a slight deformation of the object. On curved surfaces, I recommend increasing the precision by default. Make sure to unlock the axis if you wish to rotate the array's axis. Finally, there's the bolt corner. In edit mode, select your face's D bolt corner. It simply allows you to add bolts and screws to the corners of our faces. You can manage the offset to position them more or less in the center. By default, these are bolts, but we can switch to other types of screws. Or even, by enabling custom object, you can use your own assets.
Thanks for your time. If you have a few minutes, check out our other add-ons and assets. I hope BagaPie helps you. Thanks.